In this section, I'm going to talk about the mini microphone and some common feedback that we get about sound quality and intermittency with the mini microphone. With any of the Cochlear Wireless accessories, if the battery gets too low, the sound quality and or the signal can become intermittent and the sound quality can become decreased. So it's important to make sure that the battery is fully charged. When the battery is going low, on the top of the mini microphone is an LED light that should be green when the battery is fully charged, and when it's getting low, it will flash yellow. When you see that yellow light, then it's important to make sure the battery is charged up. But it's also important to think about how you're going to be using the mini microphone that day, and if you have a long lecture to go to, or you're going out for a long dinner, you may need to plan ahead and make sure that you fully charge the mini microphone so you don't have any sound quality or intermittence issues. Cochlear wireless accessories operate on a 2.4 gigahertz platform, which is just the bandwidth that the devices send their signals across. And while no other devices on the 2.4 gigahertz platform can communicate with the cochlear wireless accessories, they can interfere with one another. And there are many consumer electronic devices operating on 2.4 gigahertz. So cordless telephones and Wi-Fi routers, laptops and Bluetooth devices, even your microwave may operate on a 2.4 gigahertz wavelength. So it's easy to see how in an average home there could be some interference issues. If you do encounter some interference, which is usually a crackling or a quick drop out of the signal in and out, then you may just need to remove yourself from any interference. So check that there's not a Wi-Fi router or a microwave oven or a cordless telephone is another one that can produce interference with the cochlear wireless accessories. So moving yourself to another part of the room or into another room altogether can often fix that. Another reason for signal quality or intermittency problems is physically blocking the signal from the wireless accessory to the processor. And this can actually be as easy as covering the wireless accessory when you're talking, or when someone's talking to you in the case of the mini microphone. So make sure that, like the doctor says, if it hurts, don't do it. So you don't want to cover the microphone with any part of your body, but you also need to make sure that the person wearing the mini microphone doesn't turn their body to block the signal with a shoulder or another body part, or even make sure that when you're sitting, if you've got people in front of you, that they're not too tall, or you know, you may need to move yourself so that there's a nice direct line of sight with the mini microphone on the user. Along the same line as blocking the signal with the body part, you can also get what's called head shadow. And that is actually when if a person is wearing the mini microphone and standing in the classroom, and the signal is coming in a bit on my left side and my processor is on my right side, if I turn my head to the right to look out the window or talk to someone, then my head is actually blocking the signal from the speaker who has the mini microphone to my processor. So you need to think about where you might want to sit yourself or your child in a classroom, for instance, to make sure that the person wearing the mini microphone is actually more on the side of the processor that the signal wants to go into. If they're bilateral, of course, you want to try to sit them front on in the middle so that the signal can come into both processors. And it's also a good idea if you're in the situation or in the case of a child in school to notify the teacher that they don't turn their body and don't spend a lot of time writing on the blackboard and blocking the signal, and that they wear the mini microphone in the correct position, which is about 10 to 20 centimeters from the speaker's mouth, right, in the, if at all possible, in the center of the body, so that the speaker's voice is clear. The mini microphone does not have a swivel clip on it because it does not have a directional microphone. The microphone, which sits right here in the on the front side of the mini microphone, so the microphone is not on the top of the mini microphone, it's actually in the front. It can be positioned left, right, upside down, sideways, just not backwards, because that will obviously cover the microphone and block it. This is also helpful if you want to place the mini microphone on a table or in a situation where you're trying to get multiple speakers around you. Another reason for sound quality and intermittency is actually related to the volume of the sound coming in, which is controlled by the mixing ratio of the processor. So using the CR230 remote assistant, which is your big remote, as some people call it, you can change the mixing ratio on your processor. And the mixing ratio controls the amount of sound that you're receiving from the processor microphones versus the amount of sound relative to the amount of sound you're getting from the wireless accessory, in this case, the mini microphone. For children, the default setting is a ratio of 1:1. And that means you get 100% of the sound coming from the processor microphones and 100% of the sound coming in through the wireless accessory, which is a good thing because in a classroom, you want to be able to hear the teacher from the mini microphone, but you also want to hear the students around you and be able to listen, hear the questions that are being asked and be involved in the classroom. For adults, the default setting is 2. And that means you'll get a little bit less sound from your processor microphones and you'll still get 100% from your mini microphone. So if you want to change that accessory mixing ratio, you can use your 230 remote assistant. To change the accessory mixing ratio using your CR230 remote assistant, from the home screen, use the right arrow button and select over until you reach the settings screen. Click OK and you'll find yourself in the telecoil mixing ratio screen. Select over 1 to accessory mixing ratio, and you can see that this deals with the input from your processor microphones compared to the input from your accessory. This applies to both wireless accessories and wired accessories. To change the mixing ratio, simply push the up or down arrow buttons to select the number that you prefer. The higher the number, the less input you'll receive from your processor microphones, therefore blocking out the background noise, all the way up to 100% of the sound coming from your accessory and 0 from your processor microphones, which is a great tool to use when you want to block out background noise, such as during a telephone conversation.